Children, can any one of you tell me about noun?
Yes, Grandpa. Noun is a naming word which is used to refer to a person, place, animal, or a thing. I can explain it with an example. Look at this sentence. This is a dog. Here, the word dog is the noun which refers to an animal.
Grandpa, can I give another example for noun?
Sure, dear, you can.
For example, take the sentence, the boy looks at the man. Here, the words boy and man are nouns.
It is really wonderful, dear.
Grandpa, what are common nouns and proper nouns?
Common nouns are the names given to all persons, places, or things of the same class. Whereas, the proper nouns are the names of a particular person, places, or things. Here is an example. Look at this picture. This is the view of a city in rain. And the city is Chennai. Here, the word city is the common noun and the word Chennai is the proper noun since it refers to a particular city. Okay, Nivya, can you give another example?
Yes, Grandpa. Look at this example. Here is a cat by name Tom. Here, the word cat is a common noun and Tom is the proper noun.
That is good. Also, children, remember, all proper nouns start with capital letters. Examples are Sachin, Taj Mahal, Coimbatore, India, etc. Nivya, can you tell me how many horses are here?
There are 3 horses, Grandpa.
Good. You could count them correctly. The nouns that can be counted are countable nouns. That is why the word horses is a countable noun and the nouns that cannot be counted are uncountable nouns. For example, look at this sentence. The weather is so hot today. Here, the word weather is an uncountable noun since it cannot be counted.
Grandpa, is it true that the uncountable nouns have only one form and have no plural form?
Yes, my dear, that is true. Jenny, do you know that the nouns are either singular or plural?
Yes, Grandpa. The singular nouns refer to one person or a thing. And the plural nouns refer to more than one person or a thing. Normally, the plural nouns end with S, ES, NES or VES. But there are some exceptions. Here are some examples. The nouns at your left are singular nouns which refer to either one person, one animal or a thing. And the nouns at your right are plural nouns which refer to more than one person, one animal or a thing.
Grandpa, what are collective nouns and possessive nouns? Please explain them with examples.
Sure, my boy. A collective noun refers to a group of things, animals, or persons. For example, here you can see a shoal of fish is swimming in the tank. Here the word shoal is a collective noun which refers to the group of fish. A possessive noun shows that a person owns something. To make the noun possessive, we add an apostrophe and S to the end of the noun. Examples: Sheila's cat is beautiful. Children, it is important to know that the nouns belong to gender groups. They can either be masculine nouns, male living things, feminine nouns, female living things, common nouns, male or female, or neuter nouns, neither male nor female and not living. Here are some examples for masculine nouns. The boy is sitting. The drake is watching. And the bull is running. Here the words boy, drake and bull are masculine nouns since they refer to male living things. Here are some examples for feminine nouns. Girl, duck and cow. Here the words girl, duck and cow are feminine nouns since they represent female living things. Look at the examples for common nouns. Bird, fish and child. Here the mentioned words are common nouns since they may either be male or female. And finally come the examples for neuter nouns. House and car. Here both house and car are neither male nor female and they are not living things either. Children, I have to say something about compound nouns. A compound noun is made up of two or more words. And when the words are put together, they form a new word, which gives a different meaning. We will see it with an example. When the word I adds up with the word opener, it gives a new word eye opener, which is a compound noun with a new meaning.